Hey, what's up? This is Fate, and you're watching my tutorial on how to make maps in Team Fortress 2 using Hammer. Right here we can see the XY view, your top-down ortho view, or when you'd look at a traditional floor plan, this is the view you'd be seeing. And these are your 3D views here, and right here is your camera view used for zooming around and seeing what you've drawn. To start out, we're going to create a square brush, and we just click this white cube here to start the brush, and we're going to zoom in with the mouse wheel, and I'm just going to make a very simple cube here. There we go. And you can see here, this is how far up and down on the grid it is, and usually you'll want to drag it down a little bit. So we're going to drag that down. And now also, we're going to want to make this floor not quite as tall. I'm going to make it just 164 wide tall there. And after you're done designing the size, you hit enter to create it. Now if we push Z and go down to this camera view here, we can actually zoom in and see what we've drawn. You can use the WASD keys to move right, left, forward, back, and then use the mouse to actually look around. So as you can see here, we've made a floor. So what we're going to do next is we're going to make walls and a ceiling. And to do that, you can see that the object's selected and it's in red here, so you need to hit Escape. And now this shows that it's selected again, so we're going to hold down the Shift key and just drag this up. Now what we've done is copy that slab on top of the slab, but what we're trying to do is make a wall. So we go to the top-down view here and we drag it over to there and we have a wall, but it's not quite as tall as we want. So we go to one of the 3D views here and we just drag this up to, say, here. There, now we've created the floor and the wall, but we want a wall on all sides. So what you can do is use that hold down shift key, and while that wall's still selected, and you can tell it's selected because it's in red, you hold down the shift key and drag it over like that. And now we have a wall on this side and that side. So we want to make walls on the other two sides. So to start off, we're going to hold down shift again and drag another wall over like that. And we've got a third wall, but it's not facing the right direction. So you hold down the control key and press M, and it pulls up the transformation tool, which it automatically has rotate selected, and we want to rotate it 90 degrees on the z-axis here. So we put a 90, enter, and there we go. However, the wall, when we put it on the grid here, is a little longer than the wall we created here, so we just stretch that over. Now we have a perfect sized wall. And since we've got it the perfect size, we can just do the same thing we just learned and hold down shift and drag it down like this. And we don't have to resize it now since it's the right size, and we have four walls and the floor. So to make the ceiling, we select the bottom one here. You can select things in the 3D view or you can select them on the grid. Sometimes it's easier to do it in the 3D view, so you make sure you have the right thing selected. Now right here on one of the 3D views here on the XZ axis, we can hold down shift again and just drag this up like that. And now we have a perfect room here, and you've learned how to make a simple brush and how to copy it and create your wall. So this can be used to make a very small map, or later we'll learn how to make respawn rooms and other fun points on your map.